the first gathering of the apostles and the second gathering of Peter in the house of Cornelius, an incident, and the third gathering is once again Peter explaining the truth to the apostles. Here we find a basic current that is moving through this passage, and that current is a man called Cornelius. Though he may not know the living God, but he had the heart to spare time to hunger for God, not only himself, but insisting on the whole family that we need to wait on God and we need to pray to God and we should do the will of God. This is a unique hunger that comes from within through the inspiration and power of the Holy Spirit. This is the beginning stage of experiencing God and giving God to others. A hunger within oneself that I can do nothing without God. I need God. Without Him, all that I have is myself. Without Him, I have to face the world, its temptations, its trials, its pain. Without God, as He said in John 15:5, you can do nothing without me. And same thing we read in the Luke's Gospel chapter 5. They went and tried whole night, they got nothing. Same thing is repeated in John chapter 21. They went whole night without Jesus and they got nothing. Many of the times we try to hide ourselves in activities, in service for God, maybe even in preaching ministry, maybe in very many activities, maybe in prayer meetings. Sometime we can hide our emptiness in singing songs, maybe in conducting some prayers or helping poor, maybe caring for the sick. These are all very good, noble activities. But none of these can replace the emergence of being with God. Being with God, emptying oneself before God, realizing my roots are in God. Only when the roots are strengthened, I can stand in the world to face not only the storm but also the heat of the world. You may not have very big storm, but you may have heat. Without rain, the dry tree can be dried up. Unless the tree has deep roots, strong enough even to break the rock which is down and bring the water to keep alive the tree. So here we find a man called Cornelius, a man who deeply allows his roots to go deep into the ground of God. He might not have known the living God, but he gathered his dear ones and told them maybe that I have so much of riches, I have so much of everything, but I need God in my life. Without God, everything is empty. And his dear ones who respect him, who know his nobility, realize there is something beyond the nobility of man. There is something greater than the goodness of man. That's what Cornelius says. That is the emergence, the urgency of a man to be in touch with God. So they gathered together with all his dear ones, and when they were seeking God, it gives a great revelation. They do not know Jesus, they do not know the Lord, but the Spirit, they say in verse 12, the Spirit instructed me to go with them. That is Father Peter when he was praying. And verse 13, he says, the people who sent, they said, send someone to Joppa and fetch Simon, also known as Peter. He will bring you a message by which you and your household will be saved. 13 and 14th words, they did not know God, but they were in prayer. They realized they can do nothing with all their nobility, with all their riches. They need God. And when they hungered for God, their roots are in God. They have to be built up by the Father. And God revealed to them what they need to do, how they have to proceed in life, how they will know the living God. If they want to have fellowship with God, this is the way. Go, there is a man called Peter staying in a place called Joppa, in the house of Simon. How the Holy Spirit can give every detail when we realize that our lives are not created for us. We are not meant to live for ourselves. God, as we read in Jeremiah chapter 1 verse 4 and 5, even before you were born, I have known you and I have chosen you for a purpose. Even before you were born, I have anointed you for a mission. So my life mission and purpose is begun with a mission that came from the Father. The mission of my life is not born from me. It is born from the Father. So I have to go to the Father to know why did he create me. I need to go to the Father to know what he wants to do through me. I need to go to the Father to understand why these things are happening to me in my life. So it is in the Father my beginning, my life, and my movement. That's why we read in Acts 17:28, we live through him, we move through him, we have our being through him. And that's why Jesus said, you can do nothing without me and the Father. So they did not know Jesus, they did not know salvation, but they waited on God. And anyone who waits on God, I remember some time ago, one of our friends from Guntur, he went to the temple of Sri Salem, and he was praying in upper room because a guru taught him to pray, oh the living God, I worship you. When he was worshipping, he saw Jesus Christ on the temple wall, where there was no gods or goddess. Yes, it is a hunger for being with God. It is a hunger to realize our roots in God. It is to realize that we are not here to do something for God. We are basically called to be with Him. If we get into this bottom truth, our life is being built. My dear friends, Sangamam Plus TV is God's gift for you for our times. Like, comment, share and subscribe. God will do wonders in your life. Praise the Lord.